Hello guys, good evening. So in this video, we are going to discuss about an interesting concept called as infrastructure as code in Terraform. So in my previous videos, I have mentioned in a couple of places that Terraform is infrastructure as code. I mean, Terraform is a software which is called as infrastructure as a code, blah, 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 and something, right? So I'd like to give you more insights about, I mean, what is infrastructure as code and how, I mean, Terraform is working with that. So those kind of things I will discuss in this video. That is the intention of creating this video. Okay, so first one, infrastructure as code. So infrastructure as code is nothing but provisioning infrastructure through software. That is what called as infrastructure as a code. So how this infrastructure is created using Terraform. So Terraform uses push approach to create infrastructure. So provisioning infrastructure through software. That means Terraform is a software which is provisioning infrastructure, which is used to provision infrastructure. That is what it meant. And this Terraform uses push approach to create a software. And how this software is defined in Terraform. So we are defining this infrastructure in Terraform in the format of JSON as well as or YAML. You can use JSON or YAML. So as per my knowledge, with my experience, I'm using YAML because YAML is more readable, and it is very user friendly to create your infrastructure, define your infrastructure in infrastructure, right? So, and this Terraform uses declarative approach to create an infrastructure. I will explain you what is declarative approach. So let's say you wanted to create create an instance. So you have to mention all the properties of your instance to create that in your provider. So that is, you are declaring your the parameters or the properties of the instance, in order to create it. That is what you are declaring in a declarative way. Okay, that is what we are saying is it's a declarative infrastructure. I'll show you that once. CD demo 2, go ls. Catch EC2. That means you can see here I wanted to create an AWS instance called as test, right? So I'm mentioning the AMI, which image I have to use, and instance type, key name, and everything, right? This is a declarative way. This is what I'm declaring in my YAML that I wanted to create this instance. So I've done it in a declarative way, right? This is called as declarative approach. Okay, so come here. Then next is next is idempotent. What is mean by that? So in the left hand side, right hand side, I have mentioned that if the change matches the reality, it is not going to change anything, right? What does it mean? See, I have a task of creating an instance, not one instance. I have a task of creating two instances. I have created that once. Okay, my two instances are running. So that's fine. Now what I'm going to do is I didn't make any changes in the infrastructure. Without making any changes, what I'm going to do is I'm running the code again. If I run the code again for creating two instances, this Terraform will compare that my code with the existing state of the infrastructure. If the Terraform didn't find any changes in the infrastructure, code, it will never change anything in the provider. That means if two instances is created, that is done, and it is not going to create one more time. That is what called as idempotent, and this is exactly the behavior of Terraform as long as the resource in the provider have been created or managed by Terraform. Okay, so that is called as idempotent. And Terraform, which language we are using in Terraform for defining our infrastructure? So we are using HashiCorp language. And there is a line comparing JSON and YAML. Yeah, right. JSON, comparing with the JSON and YAML, YAML is very easily readable and editable. Okay, I am using, personally using YAML to create my infrastructure using Terraform. Okay, so next is benefits of infrastructure as code. So what is mean by that? So what is the benefits? See, automated deployment. Let's say you have a task of creating a load balancer, auto scaling group, instances, security group, blah blah blah, and everything, right? So in order to create it every time, you are doing it in automated way, right? Just run the code and create everything. Okay, so whenever you need it, You can do that, okay? And consistent variables, so we can use consistent variables entire across your code, and reusable modules. Let's say we are creating, let's say I have here, come here, I have a module, this is, consider this is a module. I have a module of creating one instance here. So if my next code, another code requires this module, I can use this module there. This is not a module actually, this is a resource. Module will come in, if it is a module, will come here instead of a resource. Okay, so this is a, consider this is a module. For an example, consider this is a module. If I want this module anywhere in my another program, I can use this here. Okay, use is there. Yeah, that is what the use of modules, reusable modules it has. Okay, and the next thing is documenting the architecture. Let's say you have a architecture of 100 instances, 10 to 12 10 to 15 ELBs, and it's a kind of a big architecture. So instead of, if you are not documenting that architecture, you cannot remember every time, and you cannot, if you want to make any changes, you can just refer the the architecture code, and you can make the changes accordingly. It's very easy to refer and manage your infrastructure, right? So the main use of Terraform is we are documenting the architecture by use of in the form of code. Okay, that is what the use of benefits of Terraform. And Terraform components, we have Terraform files, providers, and Terraform plugin and state file as a component here. We have few more components also we'll be discussing in the upcoming videos. Okay, so Terraform files, as I told you in the previous videos, I believe I have already discussed this. So whatever files which ends with the TF, .tf, which all readable by Terraform. So Terraform will read all the files which ends with the .tf. Okay, those are called as Terraform files, and we are defining all our files, Terraform files, in the extension of .tf. Okay, and providers are nothing but it's not a platform, it's an infrastructure. So we are let's say if you're using AWS cloud, your provider is AWS. So your provider is nothing but where you are creating your instances or your resources. That is what provider. Okay, so, and if you're using Azure is your provider. Okay, if you're using any other cloud, that cloud is your provider. Okay, and you can use Terraform with any providers. That's the benefit of using Terraform. And Terraform plugins, so each of the integrations will happen in Terraform through plugins. Let's say if you wanted to run your infrastructure or create your infrastructure in AWS, you have to install AWS plugin. So it's very simple, write your code and just enter the command Terraform init. Once you give Terraform init, it will install all the providers, plugins, and everything, right? So, and you can use provision bash, those kind of whatever things you need, you can do it with the plugins in Terraform. And state file, we have discussed about this state file before. I'll explain you one more time what is this state file says. So this plugin, I'll explain in this next slide. Okay, so this plugin is nothing but each plugin, plugin exposes an implement of a specific service. I have told you, right? So whatever you want to install, you can install as a plugin in Terraform. So all providers and provision are used in Terraform configurations or plugins. Provider is AWS here and provision is bash, whatever it is. I'm saying it's an example. Okay, so this is called as plugin. And state file, as I told you, state file is nothing but, let's say I wanted to create two instances in AWS. So I just ran the code in my computer, so it created my infrastructure, as well as the state of the infrastructure is documented in a state in state file called as terraform.tf state file. We have this file in my computer. I'll show you that too. I think in the last video I have shown you something else. One creating an instance here. If you go here, see, this is a file, terraform.tf state. This state file consists of so many things actually, which consists of the entire infrastructure what I have. The state of my infrastructure. See here, version is 3. It's a version of the state of file, and this is a Terraform version and serial number. See how many times, serial is nothing but serial is 11 here. So I have changed this file 11 times. So I have modified this configuration 11 times. You can see, as long as you execute the code, this serial will get changed. If I execute it again, the serial will go to 12. And lineage, I have not find anything relative to lineage in Terraform. It's a kind of a predefined thing in Terraform. I have no idea about that. So, and modules, modules are nothing but modules and resources we have. See here, we have one more thing, modules, and the next thing is outputs and resources. These are the things, these are the important things we have in Terraform, and this version is very, very important. Okay, if this version is not matching, so it won't, it is not going to make any changes in the infrastructure. So, and this is what the state file does. Version of the file, Terraform version is Terraform's version. Serial number defines how many times state files change, lineage, output of the Terraform state. And resource in the sense, what is the resources provisioned in the provider? Okay, let's say if you're provisioning instances or VPC or load balancer, that is what the resources. Okay, so next Terraform plan and apply. Okay, so it is the next state actually. If you enter Terraform plan, it will give you an overview about your infrastructure, right? And what is happening when you are giving Terraform plan? That is what I have mentioned in the three lines. It will first inspect the state file in the sense. It will inspect the state file as well as my code, whether it is matching or not, and what are the things are changed with the state file as well as my new code, and it will say that these are, and once you give Terraform plan, it will say that, and these are all things changed. I am going to install these are all the resources. That is what it says. Okay, it will first inspect the state, then dependencies. It will check the dependencies. So let's say if I'm not configuring AWS plugin, it will never go and install anything in the AWS. So that is AWS plugin is a dependency there. So it will first go to the, dependency part, it will install all the plugins next. Then it will show you the preview, what are the things needs to be changed or what are the things are going to be changed or what are the things are modified, those kind of things will be, it will display all those things. Okay, so you'll be getting a preview of everything. Okay, then if you give apply, once you are satisfied with everything, if you give apply, it will be applied. That's what. And once you give apply, the instances will be created in AWS. So I'll show you in my upcoming videos how we are going to create instances, or not instances, the resources using Terraform. Okay, that is what it does, guys. So in this video, let's summarize all those things. So in this video, we have discussed about what we discussed. Oh god, I just forgot. Yeah, infrastructure as a code and benefits of infrastructure as a code and Terraform components, plugin, state file, Terraform apply and plan. That is what we have discussed in this class. I hope this video is useful for you guys. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching my video. Have a nice day. Bye bye.